All right. So let me go into the topic. All right. Let me go into the topic. All right. So the topic that I say I'm going over is the sure mercies of David. All right. The sure mercies of David. Okay. Now, what made me want to go into this topic is because all the evil that I'm hearing going on, all the evil, I keep hearing all type of evil taking place in the congregation, man. You know what I mean? And I'm like, yo, what the hell is this? Like, yo, what's wrong with these brothers and sisters, man? And then I start, you know, I was reading and I'm like, damn, the Most High really got to have mercy upon us, man. For real. Without the Most High mercies, yo, none of us deserve to get the kingdom. None of us. You know? And during the corona pandemic, a lot of you brothers and sisters, you all have been home by yourself. And it's like the Most High is trying every last one of you all right now. Every last one of you all right now. Let me get that in Psalms 133, how beautiful when brethren come together. No, let me tell you all something. Every last one of us is being tried. You know, you're away from the congregation, you by yourself. No, it's real. Now the Lord is really showing the Most High is proving you to see if you're going to apply what you've been learning. If you really believe this truth. You feel what I'm saying? No, it's nobody around you to build you up. You know, but read that scripture for me. But during this pandemic, this is what I got a better understanding on this scripture right here. Read that for me.
Psalms 133, verse 1. Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity.
So it says how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together. Meaning when brethren come together in unity. Meaning under the same doctrine, the same mind, the same thought. The Lord said that's a beautiful thing, man. You know what I mean? It's a beautiful thing when brothers come together. Why? Why? You know, why it's beautiful? Because, let me tell you all something. A lot of us used to take for granted coming together on the Sabbath day, man. A lot of us take that for granted, man. You know what I mean? And now because of the corona, you know, we ain't seeing each other no more, man. You know, this is the first time I saw Laba in like 3 months. Yo, Laba, I miss you, man. You know what I mean? Come on, man.
What's wrong with this brother, man?
Come on, man. I love you, man. Tight. I miss you, man. Come on, man. Yo, same thing, Seth. I saw you in weeks, man. I love you, man. You know what I mean? you don't be calling me every morning, waking me up 6 o'clock in the morning. So, you know, I'll be talking to him every morning. Yo, Deacon, you up as yet? I'll be like, yeah, man, I'm getting up right now, you know.
That's yeah, how he my alarm down, clock. Deacon.
Like,
that's
if I oversleep, down. You know, once I hear that phone ring, I know it's young. Okay, I got to get up. Time for me to go to work. And on my way, I just hit him up like, yo, what's good? But, yeah, man.
Yeah, believe it or not, that's how I felt in Atlanta, man. You know what I mean? To see these brothers in Atlanta.
Right.
That's how I felt, man.
Right.
Big up to Bishop House, man. And also Riverdale.
Riverdale. Yeah, man. But you know, it's not until you see things like this happen, you understand how good it is when you got brothers around you. You know what I mean? Because a lot of times, you know, Satan attack you. Like, when you're away from brothers too long, that's the time Satan attack you. You know what I mean? When you're by yourself. So right now, the coronavirus is not just an attack on our health, but Satan is using it to attack each one of us individually to try to destroy us. You know what I mean? That's why I'm hearing about brothers and sisters in the midst of fornication, brothers and sisters in the midst of in all type of evil, you understand? You know, because you know how the scripture talk about the unclean spirit, it leave and it comes back. You know what I mean? So that's what's happening with a lot of brothers and sisters today, man. You know what I mean? A lot of y'all is away from the body. And as I said, I got a more deeper understanding when the Lord says how beautiful it is when brothers come together in unity. You know what I mean? Because sometimes you are away from the body and you come here on the Sabbath and you meet brothers, and just for that couple hours you are around brothers, man, just for that day you are around brothers, that revive your spirit, that refresh your spirit, that could take you, that could take you for another month. I'm good for a month, man. You know what I mean? I'm good for a month. You know, but when you by yourself, that's how Satan attack you. Scripture says, it says that your adversary, the devil, is like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. That's our adversary Satan, that spiritual demon. He's looking, his job is to destroy us and to get us out of this truth. You know what I mean? For us to go back into the world. That's his job. You know what I mean? And it says he's like a roaring lion. And if you all pay attention, how a lion hunt. The way our lion hunts, it look for the weak one or the brother or sister that's by itself. You know what I mean? It look for the brother or sister by itself, by theyself, and the lion attack that person. That's why we tell you all, make use of the group me. Make use of the Telegram. Make use of the sisters and brothers number that you have. Some of you all making use of it, some of you all are not. You know what I mean? And those of you all that are not, that's those of you sisters that going back banging the ex. You all know who you all are. You feel what I'm saying? That you know, going into all type of wickedness, man, fornication, you know, I ain't even want to go into it, but that's you sisters and you brothers. You feel what I'm saying? No, you brothers going and pay for, you know what I mean? You know, going and pay for, you know, come on, man.
Yeah, you remember all this time class was coming out.
Right.
I mean, people pay for advice. Yeah. This is a free advice
class.
If we from bishop all the way down to officers or soldiers, man, but people take this thing, they didn't take advantage of it.
Right.
I mean, they're thinking there was a light. Now they're by themselves. Now
right.
Satan is coming.
Right.
They don't apply nothing.
Satan coming for you. Now you start back popping pills. You know what I mean? These are the things that, understand, Satan's job is to try to destroy you. You feel what I'm saying? That's Satan's job. His job is to try to destroy you. So we are not just under a physical attack for our health. We are also under a spiritual attack. You know what I mean? Which is our mind, which is for our soul, man. You feel what I'm saying? A lot of you brothers and sisters, we don't know how long again this might last in my last couple weeks. You know what I mean? But you all need to understand you all are at war. You know, a lot of you sisters, you all in the house, you all lonely. In your mind, you all start thinking about the ex. You all reach out to the ex. You know what I mean? Next thing, the ex is over there. You know what I mean? you over there fornicating. You understand? For real. You know, this week, I'll tell you, every week, couple brothers and sisters, we got to put out for fornication. You know, because, you know, as I said, you all being tried right now. You know, and not just your kids, these young kids and them, they getting caught up in a bunch of evil too. You feel me? So, that's what prompted me to go over this topic, man. Let me get into it. Let me go to Isaiah. So the scripture says, it's good when brothers come together in unity. You know, when we come together, it's a good thing in the sight of the Most High. You know, go to Isaiah 65 and 1. You know, first I want to show you all, I'm going to touch on how Israel is, man. You know, the type of people we are. Now, you got it?
Yes, sir.
Isaiah 65 and 1. Read.
Isaiah 65 and 1. I am sought of them that ask not for me. I am found of them that sought me not. I said, behold me, unto a nation that was not called by my name. I have spread out my hands all the day unto a rebellious people.
So God said he spread out his hand all the day to a rebellious people. Believe it or not, but we are rebellious. You know what I mean? We are a rebellious people. And I got to say we because I included myself too. You understand? You know, we are a rebellious people, man. Read on.
Which walketh in a way that was not good, after their own thoughts, a people that provoketh me to anger.
That walketh what?
That provoketh me to anger.
Now read it again. Read the whole thing again.
Verse 2. I have spread out my hands all the day unto a rebellious people, which walketh in a way that was not good.
That walketh in a way that is not good. That way that is not good is going into the ways that today it's going into the ways that we have been taught here in Babylon, in America. The Christmas, the Easter, the Thanksgiving. You know what I mean? Christianity. You know, all these things. Muslim, being a Muslim. All these things is not good. All these ways we walk in, it's not good for us, man. Read on.
Which walketh in a way that was not good, after their own thoughts.
After what?
After their own thoughts.
After our own thoughts. You do what you want to do. You do whatever come to your mind, that's what you do. That's how the Negroes think. You know, the Negroes, our people, they hate order. They hate people to tell them what to do. That's why you got a lot of brothers and sisters, what they say, I'm not joining no camp. That's why I'm an individual. That's why I ain't joining no camp. You know what I mean? You don't join in no camp because you are evil and you walk after your own thoughts and you want to do what the hell you want to do. Because if you come up in here, you know we're going to tell you, brother, that's wrong. Stop doing that. Sister, that's wrong. Stop doing that. So that's why you say, I'm not joining no camp. You know what I mean? I don't wait till Yahweh shall return. Dummy. You know? Read on.
Verse 3. A people that provoketh me to anger continually to my face.
And it says that we are people, we provoke the Lord to anger continually. Meaning over and over to his face. You know, read on.
That sacrificeth in gardens and burneth incense upon altars of brick.
That sacrifice in gardens, you know. Read on.
Which remain among the graves and lodges in the monuments, which eateth swine flesh and broth of abominable things in their vessels, which say, stand by thyself, come not near to me, for I am holier than thou.
Because this is how we roll. You know what I mean? This is our people right here. Read on.
These are a smoke in my nose, a fire that burneth all the day. Behold, it is written before me, I will not keep silent, but will recompense unto their bosom.
So the Most High is going to, he said he's going to judge us, man. That's what he's going to do. All right, from there I want you to go to Jeremiah 7 and 1. The Lord said he's going to judge us. But this is Israel, man. This is our people. You know, what we're reading about here, it's talking about you Negroes. It's talking about us. You know? Read.
Jeremiah 7 and 1. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, stand in the gate of the Lord's house and proclaim this word and say, hear the word of the Lord, all ye of Judah, that hear in at these gates to worship the Lord. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, amend your ways and your doings, and I will cause you to dwell in this place. Trust ye not.
Wait, read that again.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, amend your ways.
So God command us to what?
Amend your ways.
He tell us to amend our ways. Amend our ways. Now, a lot of you brothers and sisters, a lot of y'all is doing much evil right now. You know, y'all are in the midst of all type of evil right now. The Lord command us to do what?
Amend your ways.
Fix it. Read on.
Amend your ways and your doings.
And your doings, read on.
And I will cause you to dwell in this place.
And the Most High is going to have mercy upon us. Read on.
Trust ye not in lying words, saying, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord are these.
Because at this time you had them, the prophets was lying, man. The prophets was lying. Read on.
For if ye thoroughly amend your ways and your doings, if ye thoroughly execute judgment between a man and his neighbor.
So if you thoroughly amend your ways and execute judgment, meaning you bring forth right judgment. You understand? Read on.
If ye oppress not the stranger, the fatherless, and the widow, and shed not innocent blood in this place.
And you don't murder people, shed innocent blood. Read on.
Neither walk after other gods to your hurt. Then will I cause you to dwell in this place, in the land that I gave to your fathers, forever and ever. Behold, ye trust in lying words that cannot profit.
So it says what?
Behold, ye trust in lying words that cannot profit.
So we as a people, we trust in lying words that cannot profit us. You know what I mean? Back then was the lying words of the prophets and them that was saying that Babylon is not going to come and Babylon is not going to destroy us and so forth. You know what I mean? Same thing today. We trust in the lying words of what? Our politicians and so forth. You know? We trust in these lying words. Read on.
Will you steal, murder, and commit adultery, and swear falsely, and burn incense unto Baal, and walk after other gods whom you knew not?
Read that again.
Will you steal?
Would you steal?
Murder.
Murder.
And commit adultery.
And commit adultery. Because, this is how you know it's talking about our people, man. This is how you know it's talking about Negroes. Because a Negro loves to steal. A Negro loves to murder. He loves to kill his brother. A Negro loves to commit adultery. You know what I mean? A Negro Negroes love that. Love to have sex with another man's wife. You know what I mean? We are an evil, wicked people. You feel what I'm saying? Read on. Read that again.
Will you steal, murder, and commit adultery?
Read on.
And swear falsely and burn incense unto Baal?
And worship other gods. Read on.
And walk after other gods whom ye knew not. And come and stand before me in this house.
And when you do all of this evil, you come and stand before the Most High in his house. You come up in the temple. After you do all that evil, you up in the temple. You know what that show you? It show you like you're gonna have brothers and sisters that they commit murder, they commit adultery, they steal, they in the midst of all evil. But guess what? Yet they come up in the congregation. They come into the school. Shalom, brother. Shalom, Most High Christ bless. You know? Shalom, brother, Most High Christ bless. You know? When they in the midst of all type of evil, man. Read up one more time again. Same thing for some of y'all right now online. Some of y'all right now. You all know the evil crap you all doing. You feel me? You all know the secret sins you all dealing with. You know what I mean? But read on.
Verse 10. And come and stand before me in this house.
Read it again. Read it again. Read the whole verse.
Oh, verse 9. Will ye steal, murder, and commit adultery, and swear falsely, and burn incense unto Baal, and walk after other gods whom ye knew not, and come and stand before me in this house?
So this is what our forefathers was doing. They were doing all type of evil and then coming to the house of the Lord and standing before the Lord and doing sacrifice and acting like they holier than thou. You know what I mean? That's what they were doing. You feel me? But I go here to show the spirit that our people was under, man. Our people was under. Our people back then and today, we wicked as hell, man. You know what I mean? I got to say we because, you know, you're going to find one, two brothers, but they still go off and that's why the Lord say, amend your ways. Amend fully and I'm going to have mercy on you. You feel what I'm saying? You know, when you read about Jeremiah was the only one. Everybody else was against him. They throw him in prison, all type of stuff, man. You feel me? So the Lord says he wants us to amend our ways. You brothers and sisters that's involved in all type of evil and so forth, amend your ways. You feel me? You know, so keep on, that's it on that. So I want you to go to Isaiah 60 and 2. Isaiah 60 and 2. So our people, we as a people, we always in the midst of all type of wickedness, man. You know what I mean? All type of wickedness, we always in the midst of. You know, Isaiah 60 and 2. Got it?
The book of Isaiah, chapter 60, verse 2. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee.
So read that again.
For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth.
So the scripture says, it says darkness shall cover the earth, right? Darkness is going into sin, wickedness. It says that going to cover the earth. And what?
And gross darkness, the people.
And it says gross darkness, the people. When it says gross darkness, it means more darkness. Meaning it's going to have extra darkness on the people. The people here is talking about the people of Israel, the children of Israel. So darkness is upon the earth. You got wickedness upon the earth. But guess what? Gross darkness is on the people. You understand? You all ever don't realize that when it comes to wickedness, we go the extra mile. You know, like if you watch it, you got white homosexuals and black homosexuals, right? A black homosexual, an Israelite man that following that wickedness, he gonna go extra. You know what I mean? He be flamboyant and he'll be like, you know what I mean? They be crazy. So he be going extra with it. You be like, damn, this, you know, they even take it extra where they even outdoing women when it comes to certain things. You understand? Like walking and stuff like that. They be going extra with it, man. These homosexuals. These black homosexuals. These, you know, these brothers that turn homosexuals. You know, so the scripture says darkness gonna cover the earth. But gross darkness, the people. You know what I mean? Meaning our people, when it comes to sin, and who communities got most crimes? Well, most of the crime is and so forth. Is in black, in our community. You know what I mean? Gross darkness is upon our people. We are not just that we forgot our nationality, we forgot who we are, but we are in the midst of adultery. You know, we got baby mamas all over the place. Oh, that's my baby mom. You know, you don't be hearing the Chinese talking about, that's my baby mama. Or the Japanese or Edomites. You don't be hearing white people saying, yo, that's my baby mama right there. You don't be hearing that. It's only amongst blacks and Hispanics. You understand? We are the ones that call our woman baby mama. That's my baby mama right there. Or you're going to hear the sister say, that's my baby daddy. That's not my husband. That's not my Lord, my man. That's my baby daddy. You know what I mean? It seems like we just come and just give them a baby. That's all it is. You know? And usually the kid grew up without no father. The daddy not around. Because guess what? She's screwing some other dude. You know, as I tell you, when it comes to sin and it comes to wickedness, it's rampant amongst our people, man. Gross darkness is upon our people. You feel what I'm saying? Gross darkness is upon us. When it comes to robbing and stealing and murder, you know, we as a people, we are on top when it comes to that. You feel me? We are the leading nation when it comes to committing sin. You feel me? All right. Now, when I said that, I know Esau wickedness is another level of wickedness. You understand? He don't just steal gold or steal. He come in and steal your land, your culture. His wickedness is another level of wickedness. I ain't talking about him. You know, so read that one more time again.
For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people.
And gross darkness the people. Gross darkness the people. All right, read on. So we got more darkness upon us. We as a people, we in the midst of all type of wickedness. All type of wickedness. And let me tell you something. Sometimes you think, okay, brothers and sisters, wake up to the truth that they Israel, they not going to fall into these wickedness no more. But even in Israel, you got brothers and sisters falling into wickedness. You understand? You got sisters falling back into lesbianism. You know, all of them, I'm telling you, you got, and I can't even say. You know what I mean? I ain't going to even say, but some of y'all, man, that you know, y'all be giving us headaches, man. You understand? But it says what? Read that again.
For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth.
Darkness shall cover the earth. Read on.
And gross darkness the people.
And gross darkness going to be on the people. Read on. Meaning the children of Israel. Read on.
But the Lord shall rise upon thee.
But the Lord shall rise upon thee. Read on.
And his glory shall be seen upon thee.
And the Lord's glory shall be seen upon thee. Now, there's no way. When it says the Lord's glory shall be seen upon us, what is that going into? Go to Matthew 5 and 16. You know, how is the Lord's glory seen upon us? You know, when we out there teaching this word, when we out there setting the example, teaching Israel to wake up, you know what I mean? That's how the Lord's glory is being seen upon us. You know, read that for me.
Matthew 5:16. Let your light so shine before men.
So the scripture says, let your light shine before men, meaning what? What is your light? The light that is shining is you keeping these commandments in the faith of Christ. You know what I mean? You making that light shine before men. Read on.
That they may see your good works.
And they see the good things you're doing. They see you change your life. You used to be a lesbian. You used to be a homosexual. You used to be a thief, a murderer. And you change your life. You feel what I'm saying? And these people knew you when you was wicked like that. And they see you change. You feel me? Read on. So it says, let your light shine before men. Read on.
That they may see your good works.
Read on.
And glorify your Father which is in heaven.
And the way how they're going to glorify your Father is now your parents, they knew you when you was a nigga. You understand? And you make your light shine. So your parents, they're like, damn, my son, he really changed. You know, your friends and them like, yo, this dude really changed. You know, and they're like, wait, they in IUIC have to be doing something right. You know what? I'm going to come to the school Saturday. I'm going to see what you're all talking about. You know what I mean? Because that's what usually happens. That's why it says that they might what? Read that again.
That they may see your good works.
Because when they see your good works, read on.
And glorify your Father which is in heaven.
How would they glorify the Father? By them inquiring and they coming and repenting. That's how they're going to glorify the Father. You know, so from there, I want you to go to First Timothy. One and nine.
The book of First Timothy, chapter 1, verse 9. Knowing this, that the law is not made for a righteous man, but for the lawless and disobedient.
So this is what I want you all to understand. The law, it wasn't given to us because we were all righteous. You understand? This is why the law was given to us. You know, because what? Read it again.
Knowing this, that the law is not made for a righteous man.
The law wasn't made for a righteous man. Read on.
But for the lawless and disobedient.
But for the who?
The lawless and disobedient.
But for the who?
The lawless and disobedient.
So that's who we are. Our people is a lawless. We are lawless. We hate laws. We hate government. We hate instruction. You understand? That's why the law was created and the law was given to us. Okay? Read that again one more time.
Knowing this, that the law is not made for a righteous man, but for the lawless and disobedient.
But the lawless and disobedient. Read on.
For the ungodly and for sinners.
For the ungodly and for sinners. Okay. Some of you all might say, I'm not ungodly. I'm not a sinner. Okay. Let's pull back that curtain. You know what I mean? Read on.
For unholy and profane.
For unholy and profane. Read on.
For murderers of fathers and murderers of mothers.
So some of you all might say, I don't murder my mother. I didn't murder my father. But you all is the same one that disrespecting your mother and disrespecting your father and cursing them out and ain't got no respect for them. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Read on.
For manslayers. For whoremongers.
For manslayers and what?
For whoremongers.
For whoremongers. Whoremongers is brothers that want to have sex with this woman and that woman and this woman and that woman. Some of you multiple hoes, brothers. You brothers that got multiple hoes. I'm talking about multiple wives. You all are whoremongers, man. You know what I mean? And I personally met some of you all wives, and I know some of you all, how to say. We know you all history. Some of you men that call yourself leaders that pushing that doctrine, but we ain't going to put your business out here. Some of your so-called, some of the sisters that used to follow behind you all, they here, and they tell us about all the evil. You know what I mean? One of the hosts. Oh, man. You feel me?
Deacon, you know what they say the doctrine is. You got to be a bishop. If you're not a bishop, you can have another wife. This is okay. The doctrine.
Man, I ain't gonna give them everything, man. You know what I mean? You know, I'm gonna wait for an idiot to come to me with that so I could cut them hard, rebuke them sharply. You know what I mean? But anyways, so multiple hoes. That's a whoremonger.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah, because a brother cannot control his lust, so he will find scripture to bend scriptures. I mean, to his own will. Yep. That's what's going on, man. But the brothers who say that, but I thought he considered himself as a
leader. Right.
Hey, man, but you are here pushing. You have your own way. You pushing as a leader, man. But you can have more wife because you don't choose to be a deacon or a bishop. Why don't you just go in the bottom on that and finish the whole thing up?
Right.
You understand, man? But guess what? For some of y'all who's not studying, you have dumb brothers like that confound you. You understand?
Right. All it's saying is if you're a leader. If you're a leader, you got to have one wife. Set an example. That's the law under Christ. You understand? Those of y'all want to go against it, y'all stay out there and do you, man. Well, you know, but as we say, some of y'all third, fourth wives is here. And they, you know what I mean? They repented, you know? You understand? And we know the evil stuff you men be doing. You understand? But we ain't going to put your business out there, as we said. So, anyways, read that again one more time. It's something I wanted to say. Read that again one more time.
Verse 10. For whoremongers, for them that defile themselves with mankind.
Them that defile themselves with mankind is what? Homosexual. You understand? Read on.
For men stealers, for liars, for perjured persons, and if there be any other thing that is contrary to sound doctrine.
And if it is any other thing that is contrary, so he makes sure he cover everything because he's like, man, I might forget some. If it's anything that is contrary to sound doctrine, meaning to the laws of God, you understand? That's why the laws was given. You feel me? And understand this. This is us. This is our people. Yes, you understand? That is our people. Our people is the ones that all these things cover. We are murderers. We are adulterers. We are men stealers. A lot of homosexuals. You know what I mean? All these things is what is amongst our people. We, you know, about a bunch of lesbians. You know what I mean? Give me some more of what it said. We a bunch of liars amongst our people. You know? So these is the things that's amongst our people that our people have, why the law was given to us. You know what I mean? That's why the law was given to us. So I sit back and I ask myself, because a lot of time I always share a lot of stuff, you know what I mean? And I be like, yo, is everybody just, is they just evil or something? But then I realize this is why the law was given. You understand? And then I realize Christ came for that which was sick. You feel me? So that's when I realized, like, nah. You know, so that's why I'm going to go over. That's why I'm going into this, as I said. You know? So the law was not given to you because you're righteous. You know, a lot of you are running around and you all might think you're all righteous. You understand? But the Lord said, all our righteousness is like, filthy rags. You know? So read for me, brother. Where you at?
Oh, that was the end of
That's it. All right. There's something I wanted to mention, man. Something I wanted to mention.
You want me to read 9 again?
Yeah, read it again. Something about the multiple hoes I wanted to mention. Oh. Something I want. Anyway, let's move on. He going. I probably. So from there, I want you to go to 1 Corinthians 6 and 9. So I'm showing you all the spirit that's on Israel. You know what I mean? Before I go into David, I'm showing you all the spirit that's on Israel. You know? Our people, believe it or not, our people, we as a people, we rebel against God. We break his commandments. He gave us his laws. We rejected it. We are the ones that did it in the past, man. If you know what I'm saying, some of us repented in the past same way, but we still was rebellious against the Lord, man. If you know what I'm saying, we was in the midst of adultery, fornication, whoremongering, all type of wickedness. And it's the same thing you see taking place today in Israel. You know, it's the same thing you see taking place even in some IUIC congregations. You know, as I said, everybody amongst us is not righteous. You know what I mean? Some of you brothers and sisters, some of y'all is going to get caught up in some evil. Some of y'all going to repent. Some of y'all are not. And that's just what it is. You know, but read that scripture for me, brother.
1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9.
Read.
Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God?
So understand this. If you are unrighteous, you are not going to get the kingdom of God. What does it mean to be unrighteous? Keep on reading.
Be not deceived, neither fornicators.
If you are fornicating, brothers and sisters, if you are fornicating, you're not getting the kingdom of God. Understand that. So if you're doing that, repent of it, sister. If you're doing that, repent of it, brother. What does some of you all might be confused? What is fornication? Fornication is you having sex with your ex. You know what I mean? You in coming to this truth, you know you Israel and you having sex with your ex. Fornication is you having, brother, you having sex with that sister out there in Miami congregation. You know what I mean? And nobody know. You are secretly banging each other. That's fornication. You understand? But of so much. When you read Leviticus 18, it break down all the sins of fornication. You know what I mean? So read that again.
Be not deceived, neither fornicators.
If you are a fornicator, you're not going to inherit the kingdom of God. Understand that. So those of you brothers and sisters that dealing with that spirit, get it right. You know what I mean? You could always repent of that. You feel me? Read on.
Nor idolaters.
No, you worshiping idolatry. You know what I mean? Whether it's Caesar Bogier, that white image of Christ, Christianity, being a Muslim. You know what I mean? You're not going to get the kingdom of God if you worshiping if you are in Christianity. Because in Christianity, it teach you another God. It teach you a false God. It teach you to worship Jesus Christ. That white image of Christ. That's what it teach you. So you are not getting the kingdom of God. Read on.
Nor adulterers.
Nor what?
Nor adulterers.
No, if you are adulterer, you understand? You commit adultery, even in Israel, and you ain't repent of that. And you ain't get your mind right. You ain't getting the kingdom of God. You know what I mean? Read on.
Nor effeminate.
Nor who?
Nor effeminate.
No, this is for you brothers, man. You brothers that act like a girl. You, every time you talking, you doing your hands like that. You know what I mean? Anytime I see any brother do that, I'm watching you suspect, man. Yo, why you keep moving your hands like that in front of me? Like, come on. You know what I mean? You know, are you flicking your hair? Yeah. Are you rolling your eyes? Are you on Facebook posting all your emotions, you feminine brothers? You know what I mean? you taking selfies? You know, you taking damn selfies like these sisters I'm posting it up. You know what I mean? Yo, listen, you effeminate, man. You understand? You rolling your eyes, you walking with a twitch. You understand? You effeminate, man. You know, the Bible says that if you are what? If you are effeminate, you are not going to have to get the kingdom. So when you effeminate, it means that you act like a girl. You might not be dealing with, you might not be involved in homosexuality as yet, but you still have woman tendencies in you. Effeminate is a man with woman tendencies. You know, woman tendency, woman, he acts like a woman. Okay, read on.
No abuser of themselves with mankind.
Abuser of yourself with mankind is going into homosexuality. You understand? Read on.
No thieves. No covetous.
No what?
No thieves.
No thief. If you are a thief, you're not getting the kingdom of God. You brothers and sisters out there, you all understand this. If you are a thief or you covetous, if you get them spirits on you, repent of them. You understand? If Christ return and you still got these spirits on you and you never repent of them, you're not inheriting the kingdom of God, man. You understand? Read on.
Nor drunkards.
Nor drunkard. Meaning you drinking, not in moderation, but you drinking and you staggering. You know, you staggering, you have no control over your mind or your faculties. You know what I mean? That's being a drunkard. You know, you want to fight everybody when you drink. You know, read on.
Nor revilers.
Nor who?
Revilers.
Revilers or revelers? What it says there? It's
revelers.
Revilers, right?
Yeah, it's revilers.
Okay. All right. Go ahead.
Nor extortioners.
Nor extortioners, meaning you extorting somebody. Meaning you forcing somebody to give you money or whatever. You understand what I'm saying? Read on.
Nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God.
Shall
inherit the kingdom of God.
So you're not going to inherit the kingdom of God if you're doing any of these things. You know what I mean? And you don't repent of it. And you don't repent of it. Read on.
And such were some of you.
And such were what?
Some of you.
So what does this says about the church of Corinth? In the church of Corinth, there were liars. They were adulterers. They were abusers of themselves with mankind. There were effeminate men inside there. Now, let me tell you, that's why Paul had to get on the church of Corinth and says it's against nature for a man to have a long hair, because Paul was dealing with the same thing we deal with today. You know, the brother was effeminate, and Paul was telling him, listen, you cut your damn hair, you effeminate, you acting like a girl. You understand? You know, that's why Paul was going into that, you know. You know what I mean? But he said, you want to be argumentative, you know. That's why Paul is addressing. He said, if you effeminate, you ain't getting the kingdom, man. Go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, he was getting on brothers who was acting like
that. Right. You know what I mean? Like, I remember one time I went to this congregation. I saw a dude with a perm, man, and his thing was all the way down here. So I'm like, yo, I'm sitting in the congregation like this. I'm like, you know, you remember the dude? I'm watching, yeah, man. You remember was one of the states you was on. So I'm like, yo, I'm watching at the leaders. I'm watching to see if any of the leaders going to say something. I said, what the hell is this, man? I said, this dude look like a straight girl up in here, man. And I'm watching the leaders like, would these dudes say anything to this boy, man? You know what I mean? So like, yo, man.
Help the boy
out. Yeah, I'm like, yo, man, you can't be coming up in here with that no damn perm here. You know, looking like a girl, man. I have to tell the leaders, when you all see brothers like that, you all better check them, man. You know what I mean? Dude probably was like 17, 18. I don't know, man. But, yo, you can't be, men cannot, you cannot be coming up in here like no with no perm looking like a girl, man. A lot of people in Atlanta, they do that. You know, in Atlanta, a lot of them, they perm their hair. That's like, Riverdale. You know, but yeah, man. So the scripture says, and such will some of you. So when I read that, I'm like, damn. You never know what a lot of these brothers and sisters that's amongst us, what they was dealing with. Because the law was not given to the righteous. It was given to sinners. You know what I mean? A lot of us, before we come into this truth, we all was caught up in different demons. We all had different demons on us. You know, whether it's a covetous demon, a murderous demon, abuser of the self and mankind demon, lesbian demon. You know what I mean? Whatever it is. You understand? Now, let me tell you some concerning the lesbian demon and the homosexual demon. You know, if you used to be a homosexual and you up inside here, you need to wait. Don't run and marry no sister, man. Don't run to marry no sister. You understand? You need time to get that demon off of you. You feel what I'm saying? And I do think you're supposed to let the sister know that you used to be in that lifestyle. You got to let the sister know that you plan to talk to, like, yo, I used to be a homosexual. And it's going to be up to that sister whether she won't mess with you or not.
Yeah, but you heard that thing before where brother thought, I'm saying, sister be complaining, say, brother always go in the back, never hit the never do the front. That's that spirit.
That's I ain't even going there.
That's the spirit.
I ain't even going there, man. I never go to the front. Okay. So so my thing is this.
No, like, what I'm saying, Deacon, he been married for 2-3 years. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. That's crazy. You know that's crazy. You know, brother got a wife, and anyway, let me don't go there. You know what I mean? But this is what I'm saying. No, we had sisters that used to be lesbians. Some of them got married and they happy, you know what I mean? They got this one sister, she mad cool, you know what I mean? You know, I give her enough respect. I like that sister. But then you got some other sisters, they came out of lesbianism, you know, they came and they rushed into marriage and they never had time to heal themselves. You know what I mean? So now when they in that relationship with their husband, you know, is a lot of problems arising. Sometimes the brother might speak loud. Like, you know, sometimes, you know, you might tell your wife, yo, what you doing, man? Why are you yelling at me? You know, you verbally, I just asked you what you doing. I talk low. Why are you crying? You know what I mean? Not just that. Not, when a woman, like, some of these demon sisters need time to get themselves to heal of that demon, man. You feel what I'm saying? You know, I remember one sister used to be a lesbian. This couple of sisters rush into relationship that used to be lesbians. They back into the world being lesbians. Again. They left the brother, had a baby with the brother, and left him, went back into the world being a lesbian. You know what I mean? That's why I said sometimes people need time to heal. You rush and you get married. No, I can't say she rushed. This sister was with us for like 5 years. 5 years, but guess what? She couldn't endure. She used to be a lesbian. And when the husband dealing with her, she crying. Why are you crying? You know? I'm like, yo. So
yeah, because I miss my partner.
Yeah, man. I'm telling you. You know, so brothers and sisters, if you all had that spirit on you, you all need time to heal. You know what I mean? And you all ain't going to be doing none of that funny business up inside you straight up. You know, if you repented of that, you come up in here, you repented of that, we don't want to hear you going back to that lifestyle. We don't want to hear you hanging around the same company. You know what I mean? I tell you, just the other day, I talking to this sister, I said, I ain't see you in a while. You know, she herself was struggling with that too. You know, she was a little tomboy. She was struggling with that. And I see her put on lipstick and she trying to be girly. And I was feeling good. I said, yes, this sister changing, you know what I mean? But then she go back around the same company, disappear for a couple weeks, you know, and you know that I'm like, yo, man. So I saw the sister, I said, yo, sis, you can't give up the fight, man. You can't let Satan mess with your head. You feel what I'm saying? Don't give up. You know what I mean?
Believe me, he's a heavy demon too.
Yeah. So we know it's a demon and it's a heavy demon, but it attack you, brothers and sisters, even more because you all home by yourself. You all ain't calling nobody. You all ain't talking to nobody. You all under quarantine and you all secluded. You know? Anyways, All right, I don't jump all of that. Let me just go into the topic. Well, that's part of the topic. We dealing with this part here. I'm just going into how we as a people, we got dealing with all type of different sins. We got all kind of hang-ups. We got all kind of demons on us. Even you brothers and sisters that's in here right now. You know what I mean? Everybody got different things they dealing with. You know what I mean? But that's why you all are here, to get healed. You understand? Now, I'm going to go. I want you all to see the spirit that the things, some of the sins our forefathers deal with. I'm going to go over David. All right? I want you to go to 1 Samuel 6 and 1. Let's start with David. 1 Samuel 16 and 1. 1 Samuel 16 and 1. I'll show you all some. You know?
1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 1. And the Lord said unto Samuel, how long wilt thou mourn for Saul, seeing I have rejected him from reigning over Israel?
So let me tell you all something. After a while, sometime the Most High going to reject you. You know what I mean? Some brothers and sisters, the Lord reject them, man. You know, that's why you see no growth there. They here in the congregation. And, you know, you could tell they not here. You could tell the spirit is not the same. You know what I mean? And we like, damn, that brother, why is he taking so hard to recover himself? What's going on with that brother? You know, what happened to that brother is God reject him. Some of you brothers and sisters inside here, you all here and you all just here, but you all are not here. You understand? Something you went through inside here changed you. You know what I mean? Something you did wrong. Something you did. Sometimes you could commit certain sins where God could reject you. You know what I mean? That's why you got to be careful what you do. You know what I mean? All these dudes that you see left up out of here, God reject them, man. You know what I mean? When you see what they doing, they start cooking on the Sabbath, grilling on the Sabbath. You see them on the Sabbath grilling. The Sabbath is in the morning now. You know, all type of evil you hear coming from them. Why is this happening? You got to ask yourself, why? Because God reject them. God rejected them. No matter how much scriptures you could pull and show up some men, once God reject you, that's it. At this time, God rejected King Saul because King Saul was being rebellious. King Saul wasn't listening to instruction. So God rejected him. So read that one more time again.
And the Lord said unto Samuel, how long wilt thou mourn for Saul?
So Samuel was mourning for Saul. Samuel was like, oh gosh, I love Saul, man. Like, Lord, why you rejecting him, man? You know? But the Lord tells Samuel, he said, listen, man, stop crying for Saul, man. Stop worrying about me not dealing with Saul no more. Read on.
Seeing I've rejected him from reigning over Israel.
I rejected him. He ain't going to be the king no more, man. Read on.
Fill thine horn with oil and go. I will send thee to Jesse the Bethlehemite.
Okay, so from there I want you to jump to verse 11.
Verse 11. And Samuel said unto Jesse, are here all thy children? And he said, there remaineth yet the youngest, and behold, he keepeth the sheep. And Samuel said unto Jesse, send and fetch him, for we will not sit down till he come hither. And he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy and withal of beauty, a beautiful countenance.
So it says that David was ruddy. Now, when Edomites, a lot of Edomites, they use that to say that David was red. You understand? But that's not what it's going into. All it's saying is David was young and he had beautiful skin, man. He was young and he was handsome. He had no blemish in his skin. You understand? You know, he was ruddy. Like for instance,
let me see if I'm ruddy now.
Nah, I got cuts and all of that.
Oh, please, you know? please.
But I'm ruddy. Deacon, I say I'm a little ruddy, right? Like, look at my skin complexion. You see that? Somebody poured the thing. You know, like you see how I'm dark and you could barely see blemish in my skin? You know what I mean? That's ruddy, you know? I don't know about this dude right here.
I'm two-tone black. One light skin, one dark.
Oh, man. But, you know, it's no blemish. You know what I mean? When you have no blemish, you know, no pimples on your face, none of that crap. You know what I mean? That's how King David was. You know, he was a handsome brother. You understand? Read on.
And he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy and withal of a beautiful countenance, a goodly to look. And the Lord said,
He was goodly to look upon. You understand? He was very handsome, King David. Read on.
And the Lord said, arise, anoint him, for this is he.
So David was anointed to be king in Israel. Read on.
Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward.
And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David. So the Lord started dealing with David from that day forward. You understand? When you keep on reading in the history, too, David start. He was a warrior. He killed Goliath. You know, he was murdering a lot of the enemies of Israel, man. You understand? And the Lord was dealing with David. You know, so from there, I want you to go to 2 Samuel 11 and 1. 2 Samuel 11 and 1. So the Lord was dealing with David. You know, when you go to Acts, it tell you that David was a prophet. But guess what? David had flaws. David made mistakes. But I'm going to show you the difference with David mistakes and a lot of the mistakes that you brothers and sisters make today. You understand? Read.
2 Samuel 11 and 1. And it came to pass, after the year was expired, at the time when kings go forth to battle, that David sent Joab and his servants with him and all Israel. And they destroyed the children of Ammon and besieged Rabbah. But David tarried still at Jerusalem.
So David didn't go to war. He was chilling in Jerusalem, you know. Read on.
And it came to pass in the evening tide that David arose from off his bed.
At the evening tide, meaning in the afternoon, it said David arose out of his bed. Read on.
And walked upon the roof of the king's house.
And he was on the roof, all right, of the king's house. Read on.
And from the roof, he saw a woman washing herself.
And on the roof, he what?
He saw a woman washing herself.
He saw a woman taking a shower. She was washing herself. You know? Read on.
And the woman was very beautiful to look upon.
And the woman was very beautiful to look upon. Read on.
And David sent and inquired after the woman.
And David sent to find out, yo, who is that woman down there? You know what I mean? But let me show you all something. What just took place here with King David and that woman that was washing herself? Now, David was on his roof and he saw the woman washing herself. She was butt naked taking a bath. You know what I mean? And not just that, the scripture says the woman was beautiful to look upon. Now, a lot of you brothers, I know you all deal with this. You understand? Where you see certain women, and when you see them, you gotta control yourself. You gotta control your eyes. You gotta be like, yo, don't look, look away. You know what I mean? Because some woman is built a certain way, and some woman, the way how they built it, you know, it could put a spirit on you. You know what I mean? So this woman, she ended up putting a spirit on King David. You understand? What spirit she put on him? The spirit of lust. You know? No, I want you to go to Sirach 9, read verse 5.
The book of Sirach, chapter 9, verse 5.
Sirach 9, verse 5. Read on.
Gaze not on a maid.
So the scripture says, don't gaze on a maid. No, let me show you all something. That was one of the mistakes that David made. He gazed on that woman. He saw her naked and he gazed on her. He was like, damn, what you got? You know, he couldn't take his eyes off. He was like, he kept looking. You see somebody naked bathing, instead of you turn away your head like, damn, I don't supposed to be looking at that. He was like, oh, smack. He was up there. He probably like got some popcorn and sit down just watching. Like, he probably came out like every other afternoon just to look to see her bathing. He knew what time she coming out to take a shower to bathe. You feel what I'm saying? And let me tell you all something. I'm not going to go there. I was fin to say something, but you telling me that woman couldn't tell that the king was up there and he could see her? You feel what I'm saying? You telling me that woman, like, you know, didn't tell the king, no, the king was up there and he could see her washing herself. You know what I mean?
Hey, Dick, you know in the islands they do that, right?
Yeah, I know.
You know the sisters do that. They go, they take showers in the rain.
Yep.
I remember a little kid, you see, you like.
It is true.
Yep. You know, so read that scripture again for me.
Gaze not on a maid.
So it says, don't gaze on a maid. That's why since I came into this truth, I tried to train myself not to gaze on a maid. You know, like you see a female and that female look bad. You know what I mean? Instead of, you know, you on the street, you walk and you see some bad female. You know what I mean? You learn to control yourself. You know, don't gaze after her. You know what I mean? You like.
They stop traffic.
Some of you brothers be doing that with your wife around. And your wife complaining. Like, Deacon, he was watching her and I was right there. I said, bro, what the hell is wrong with you, man? You got to learn to control yourself. Control your eyes, man. You know what I mean? You can't, and your wife there and you doing that? Like, you brave, man. Like, come on. You know, you got to learn to control yourself. But King David, he made that mistake.
Yeah, man, sometimes, even though, I had a sister. I said, if you know your husband going, look, why you just cannot wait to say you got him. You know, some sister be like, as soon as see the person coming, she's staring at her husband. Yep. She's staring at her husband, looking at her, look at him in the corner of her eyes. Because she know what their husband going to do.
Right. Yeah, because every wife know their husband, you know what I mean? I'd rather not tell you all something. I'm going to, I know she watching right now, so. You know? But every woman know their husband, you understand? Yeah. But we as men, you got to learn to control your mind, control your eyes. Let me get that. I made a covenant with my, what Job said. Yeah. Get that and read it real quick, you know? Because it's not something that you could just overcome overnight. You know, those of you brothers that are dealing with lust, those of you brothers that come from the world, you know, every time you see a big booty, you turn it around like, damn, yo, you know what I mean? You brothers that come from that, they take time to train yourself to stop doing that. But you got to stop doing that. You know, sometimes you're going to see a best thing coming by and you got to learn to don't look at it like, I'm not going to look. Okay, look away. And that's how you got to train yourself. You know what I mean? You got to train yourself, man. That's a training slang. Best thing. You know, you got to train yourself. It's nothing that, and you can't just do that all, and you don't just come overnight. You take training. You train yourself. You understand? So read that for me again.
Job chapter 31 and 1. I made a covenant with mine eyes.
So Job said he made a covenant with his eyes. Now, we as men, we got to learn to make covenant with our eyes. You know what I mean? Sometimes you might break that covenant. When you break the covenant, you better repent. You know what I mean? And just get your mind right. You feel me? But it says what? Read that again.
I made a covenant with mine eyes.
Job said he made a covenant with his eyes. Read on.
Why then should I think upon a maid?
And because when, you know, for what help you from thinking upon another maid is by you is when you not looking at her. You're not looking and lusting after her. You understand? So go back to Sirach and read that again.
Deacon, this is a good example of what you're talking about. When you see a woman and then you looking so hard, they say, bro, relax. So this is a scene from Life. Can't get right. Sees this. Don't worry about the Edomite woman. But can't get right, sees this Edomite woman. Remember, they all in jail. And then you're going to see what Eddie Murphy says to him. Go ahead, play the clip real quick. It goes exactly what you're saying. Turn it down. I didn't know they were going to play this music. They put a song over it.
No
Hold up. There goes his face right there. Pause it, pause it. No, go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. Back, 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 back. You never seen life? Hey. Right there.
Yeah, that's some of you face. Brothers. Yeah, when you see, you see. That's it?
Yeah, they put music over it. I didn't realize they put the music over it. But when you watch the scene, they telling him, calm yourself down. Control yourself. Control yourself. Because he had his mouth all the way wide open. Go forward a little bit. A little more. A little more. Oh, yeah, go back. Right there. Right there. Right there. Right there. That's that look.
Oh, man. Oh, man. All right. So, yo. You know what I mean? Read that one more time for me again.
Gaze not on a maid.
So the scripture says, don't gaze on a maid. When you see big booty,
Judy.
Big booty Judy walking down the street, you know what I mean? And you see her coming from a distance, just turn your head real quick. You understand? That's across the street. That's the only way you could escape the traps and the trials of the devil, man. Don't get me wrong. Sometimes it be too late. The image is already there. You're like, oh, smack. You know, no, you got to get it out of your head. You feel me? But this is what you got to do. You cannot gaze on a maid, man. You understand? You got to train yourself not to do that. That's going to prevent you from committing adultery. That's going to prevent you from lusting. You feel what I'm saying? Read.
Yeah, I mean, like sometimes is to some brother, it become like a habit.
Yeah.
You have to rejoin yourself from that.
Yeah. Well, I'm keeping it straight. I used to love watching big booties. You know what I mean? That was me. You know, some of y'all could be like, whatever. Deacon, I don't care what you all think. You know, Paul was straightforward. You understand what I'm saying? Paul said, listen, I got evil concupiscence in me. That was one of my things. I love watching big booties. A lot of you brothers, you all love doing that probably. You know, I had to train myself not to do that. You understand? I had to train myself when I see females, don't watch and lust after them. I had to train myself when I came to truth not to do that. You feel me? So you men, you have to train yourself not to do it. When you see something, you turn away real quick. You understand? Right. Oh, you got to watch it. She got AIDS. She got herpes. Mm-hmm. She got all type of sickness. Now, I mean, that's all you got. You got to put that in. You got to train yourself not to do that. You understand? Otherwise, you could end up falling into some stuff. You could end up falling into lust. Now you watching her. Now you want to talk to her. You know what I mean? Now you, every morning, you know she passed by 7 every morning. You out there 7 or more every morning just to say what's up to her. Hey, beautiful, how you doing? You know what I mean? Yes.
Yeah, remember, Deacon.
Huh?
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. Yeah, remember, there's spirit beyond sisters too.
Right, yeah, man. Yep, you got some sisters, same thing too. They be lusting hard. You know what I mean? They be seeing brothers, lusting after brothers. You know, some of you sisters got toys in the house. And you all lusting, doing certain things. You all know what you all doing.
Yep.
Because I be hearing. You understand? You know, I be hearing, you know, certain thing. I'm like, what? She doing that? What? Yeah. So we know you all dealing with lust too, man.
That's why when you talk to some sisters, they will tell you that, oh, I'm not waiting for a Lord yet.
Right.
Because she's doing her thing.
Right.
She's doing her thing. She don't need no Lord. She's doing her thing.
Yeah. Yep. She doing her thing. If you all know, could, would, what that mean. You know what I mean? But anyways, so the script, where we was at again? Read that again.
Sirach chapter 9, verse 5. Gaze not on a maid.
So the scripture says, don't gaze on a maid. You see a beautiful woman, don't gaze on her. Read on.
That thou fall not by those things that are precious in her.
And what's the things that's precious in her? Her booty, her titties, you know what I mean? What else? What's some precious things? That's about it for black men, you know what I mean? The hips, the booties, the ties, the face. She got a beautiful face.
Yeah, the way God made it, man.
Yeah, she got that. She looked like Eve, you know? So the scripture says, don't look on her because you're going to be what? Read that again.
that thou fall not by those things that are precious in her.
Because you could fall by the things that's precious in her if you're watching it and you gaze and you're like, you know what I mean? You know, it could mess with your spirit. It could mess with your mind. You understand? When you're watching it, it's like the things that's precious in her, you're like, damn, what? Like, yo, look how she built. And you going crazy. You lost your damn mind. Now you running and trying to get her number, and you married. You know what I mean? Now you forgot about Yahawa Shai. You know what I mean? Now you like, Yahawa Shai who? You know? Sister, let me get your number. You know what I mean? No, you forgot about Yahawa Shai. No, you forgot about Christ. You know what I mean? No, you got the sister number talking, you know? But read that again.
Gaze not on a maid, that thou fall not by those things that are precious in her.
Because you can fall, man. If you're gazing on her booty, most black men, that's what they mind be on, the booty. You know, you gazing on her booty, you going to fall, man. You feel what I'm saying? Read on.
Give not thy soul unto harlots.
Okay, so this is for you. I want you to jump to verse 8.
Verse 8. Turn away thine eye from a beautiful woman.
So this is what you have to train yourself to do. Some of you always like, what deacon talking about? Turn away his eye. He turned away. This is what God tell us to do, man. David didn't do this. That's why David got trapped up. You understand? David didn't do this. That's why David got trapped up. David looked on Bathsheba and he fell by those things that was precious in her. Because Bathsheba was bad. You know what I mean? She was bad to the bone. And David fell. You know what I mean?
Deacon, you got to think about it too. If he's up there looking at her, right? Yeah. She know she can see him just like he can see her.
Yeah, sometimes. So I wouldn't put it past that, man. You know what I mean? I wouldn't put it past her. You know, that she saw the king watching her. You know, some woman is like that. Some woman, they're going to do things to appease men, to seduce men, for you to fall. You feel what I'm saying? Some woman is like that. Sometimes Satan jump on woman. You know, let me get that scripture, the wicked woman searched for the precious soul. You know, let me show you how some women roll, man. You know, now last week I'm working. I got two of my workers and them, you know, they working. You know, you got two sisters, they waiting for, they on the block, they trying to get a parking, right? So, them, my workers and them, they talking to the sisters, they're like, yo, da 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 da. So, you know, I ain't paying them women no mind. I'm trying to get out of there, you know what I mean? And they single me out, calling me. I'm like, yo, what's up? They're like, I know you from somewhere. I'm like, nah, you ain't know me from nowhere. They're like, I'm like, yo, this is Satan, you understand? But as a spiritual man, I already know the wicked woman search for the precious soul. So you can't come around me with no flattery talking about, you know what I mean? I know you or you look buff or look at your muscles or try to flutter me. You know what I mean? That I'm so, you know what I mean? You can't get me like that because I know what? The wicked woman search for the precious soul. You feel what I'm saying? Some of you brothers stupid as hell. You know? One time I saw my ex, she talking about I looking buff. I'm like, yo, what the hell, bro? You know what I mean? I already know it's Satan. You understand? Like, you can't get me like that. But some of you brothers, you're simple as hell. A woman tell you or some flattery, something flattery, or she flatter you or something like that, you don't lose your damn mind. You understand? You know, but I know, you know when Satan's job is to destroy you, man. You feel what I'm saying? Satan know who you are. Satan know who I am. Satan like, okay, you remember that scripture said, Paul I knew with the demons that was in the sons of Sceva. And the demon said to them, he said, Paul, I know, Christ, I know, but who the hell is you? So the demons and them, they're like, yo, that's Deacon Malachi right there. You know, that's so-and-so right there. Yo, I heard they be killing demons like crazy. They cast out a lot of demons. You know what? Let me see if I could try him. I'm going to try him. See if I could get him. You know what I mean? Let me see if I could get him to watch out my booty. You know, demon, because the demons see you And the demon know the sister start shaking up behind even more harder. What do you think that is for? It's to mess you up. You know what I mean? It's to mess you up. Let me see if he overcome that spirit of watching that booty. You know what I mean? Breaking his neck. You know, so now the demon walking on the street and you like. You know? So the scripture says the wicked woman, they search for the precious soul, man. And it's all about controlling. You know, it's something that you brothers got to learn to do. You got to learn to control yourself. Learn to control the spirit. Learn to control your mind. You know what I mean? You sisters too, you all got to learn to control your mind. Learn to control your spirit. Learn to control yourself, man. You know what I mean? Because some of you sisters, you're worse than brothers, man. You're worse than brothers. And we know what you all be doing too. Don't think we don't know. You understand? We read it in Corinthians early on. The unrighteous is not going to inherit the kingdom of heaven. You know what I mean? If we commit adultery, we commit fornication, these things, we are not going to get the kingdom of heaven, man. You know what I mean? So, read on.
Proverbs chapter 6, verse 26. For by means of a whorish woman, a man is brought to a piece of bread.
Read on.
And the adulteress will hunt for the precious life.
So, you got adulterous woman. That's a demon. They are hunting for the precious life. They hunting, man. You know, that's what they doing. They hunting and they know who you are. You a brother. You keep the precious life is you brothers and you sisters that are trying to keep the laws in the fear of Christ. And here come that ex or here come that adulterer, that fornicator, and they trying to entice you to go back into your old ways. You know what I mean? That's what they do. You feel what I'm saying? You know, hit you up on Facebook. Yo, I was just thinking about you. You're like, damn, why this person hitting me up on Facebook? You know what I mean? Why you think that is? You know, some of you are going and type on Facebook and looking up your ex, looking up this person or that person because you might be going through some problems in your marriage. You know, you might not feel satisfied, you know, in your marriage. You know what I mean? Some of you brothers might be satisfied. You thinking about, yep, damn, my ex used to drop it at his heart. This new sister, she just, you know,
she just sitting there.
She, yeah, just lying there.
Just eat ice cream. That's it.
You know what I mean? You know, there's no excitement with her. Now you start thinking about your ex that used to drop it at his heart. That's how Satan be getting some of you all, man. Same thing with sisters. You know what I mean? You had this one sister, you know, she told this brother, she said she dreamt her ex was hitting it hard from the back. And I'm like, that's what she told you? She had that dream? She dreamt her ex was having sex with her in the shower and hit it. I said, get rid of that hoe, man. He said, I love her. No. I said, you an idiot. Don't ever come to me for no advice again, man. You know what I mean? I said, yo, I'm not putting her away. I love her. You know what I mean? No, she left him. She left the truth and she got him on child support. No, she twerking. I said, she a hoe. I said, don't marry her. Leave her alone. Yeah, brothers don't want to listen.
Yeah, but that was their backdoor marriage again.
Backdoor marriage. You know what I mean? You know? Anytime a woman dreaming about another man, her desire is not unto you. Anytime a woman dreaming about another man having sex with her, another man, yo, her desire is not unto you.
Yeah.
Her desire is unto that other man that she dreaming breaking her back out. You know what I mean? So, yeah, these are the things that happen.
Yeah, let's get that in Genesis.
Yeah.
Let's get that in Genesis. They don't think that's our word.
You know, right, right, right.
That's what God said. I mean, if she not desire, she desire another man. I mean, she her lawyer is to this the other man. That's why God made the woman like that. That's why, yep, you guys don't understand. So anytime you desire another man that is not of you, that is not your husband, you out of the pocket.
Yeah, usually who humble a woman, that's who she her desire going to be unto. Whichever, yeah, man that humble her.
That's right. But my Babylon tell you that that's okay. To think like that, that's okay. Go ahead.
Genesis 3:16. Unto the woman, he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception.
Mm-hmm.
In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband.
You see that? Your desire shall be to your husband. That's why a lot of time you have marriage problem because her desire is not to you. You know what I mean? Her desire is not to look to see what you want, what she should have done for you. It's all about her desire, what she wants you to do for her.
A lot of relationship, automatically the sisters start thinking like that, the relationship going to have problem in it. You know what I mean? You should have to come as a gift to their relationship. You understand? Automatically she have her own mindset, the way she want her thing to be. That's why you see all these marriage is not going, is not doing well, because her desire is not to that man. You understand? She was after her lust for that moment. Then a lot of them, deacon, they will come with their husband. They see our young men. They're willing to dump their husband, you know what I mean, right, to jump in a new wife.
Right.
You understand?
Right.
That's you what have, they're
you,
about.
Hey, you had one sister try that crap, you know what I mean? She said, I tell her, yo, you going to stay with that man? She said, she don't want to listen to my kong, so she want to go to the other deacon. Yeah. You know what I mean? I'm like, yo. You know, he ain't no, we all have one mind. You ain't going to try to use a deacon against another deacon. You know, when I told the other deacon, he was even much pissed. He was like, what? You know, he went crazy, you know. I was like, yo, I did it the nice way with you. You know what I mean? You married your husband this year. You all came in here together. But you all got kids together. You know what I mean? But the brother, you watching another brother in another state. I want to get rid of this brother. No, you're going to stay with that dude. Both of you all come here together. You all going to repent together. You all going to grow together. And no, you getting rid of him and getting some new penis over there in another state. You understand? That ain't happening.
Yeah, their mindset is, you know what I mean, when sisters, they were complaining about their husband is too short or whatever that may be. Is their lustful demon? Is their lustful demon? You know what I mean? And things that they watch on TVs, the things that they, you know what I mean, their desire of.
Right.
You understand? Because if your desire towards your husband, you're gonna make it work. You understand? You're gonna make. You know what I mean, that's the man God give you. Make it work. Man, but a lot of time their lust that is in them is not trying to make that works, because she used that as a problem. You know what I mean? But then she was in the world, there was no problem. You know what I mean? Sleeping with all these short, there was no problem. Now, the Lord bless her with a short, now she got problem.
All right. So, yo, let's go back to King David. You know? So, go back and read that again for me.
2 Samuel chapter 11, verse 3. And David sent and inquired after the woman, and one said, is not this Bathsheba, the daughter of Elam, the wife of Uriah the Hittite?
So the wife of Uriah the Hittite. Why it's called him a Hittite? Because that was the land he was living in, but he was Israel. You know what I mean? He was not a Hittite. Okay, he was living in that land. Okay, read on.
And David sent messengers and took her, and she came in unto him, and he lay with her, for she was purified from her uncleanness, and she returned unto her house.
So read that again. There's a lot inside here, man. You know what I mean? When I read the scriptures, I be imagining what's going on, what's taking place. My imagination is like, you understand? So when I read, that's how I be, you know, that's how I see things. When I read, I try to understand what, like, and imagine what's going on, what's taking place. You know? Read that again one more time.
And David sent messengers and took her, and she came in unto him, and he lay with her.
And he what?
And he lay with her.
So it says that she came in unto him, and he what?
And he lay with her.
And he laid with her. David had sex with Bathsheba. You understand? He had sex with her. Read on.
For she was purified from her uncleanness.
Because she came off her uncleanness. You know what I mean? She wasn't under uncleanness. She came off her uncleanness. And when she came off her uncleanness, he said David had sex with her. She came in unto him, and he had sex with her. You understand? Read on.
And she returned to her house.
And she went back to her house after. So imagine what taking place. David called Bathsheba. Bathsheba, she came to King David's palace. She and David sit down talking, whatever, whatever, whatever. You understand? And it meet the point where what? Where King David went and had sex with her, lay down with her. You understand? And she what? She also was consent to that too. You understand? She gave it up to David.
Deacon.
She didn't say, no, David, stop. It's wrong. She didn't do a Susanna. She gave it up to David, man. You understand? She had sex with David. She wasn't innocent in this.
Deacon.
Bathsheba wasn't innocent.
You're 100% on point. Because look at that in verse 4, right? Deacon Laba was just talking about this. He said, why did they put that in there? For she was purified from her uncleanness.
Right.
Letting you know that she knew. She waited till she was right.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? She waited till she was right, and then she went over there to the king and was like, hey, you know, I'm good to go now.
Yep. Yep. Yep.
You remember that, see, that king went to inquire of her.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like you just said, Zaphaniah. She waited. You understand? Then why would they put that there?
Right. Yo, some woman, some of you women, your mind is like clothespin. You know what I mean? What I mean a clothespin, those are y'all that used to wash clothes and hang it on the line outside and put it to dry. You know the clothespin that you clip the clothes with? You know, I don't think you all know about it. It's a, you know, but a clothespin, when you squeeze the head, the leg open. You know what I mean? That's how some of you sisters is, man. You're simple as hell. Somebody squeeze your head, play with your head a little, your leg open. Like, you know what I mean? That's how a clothespin is. You know? So Bathsheba, she willingly went and lay down and had sex with King David, man. You understand? Number one, it could be because, you know, King David was a handsome brother. And he was, and he had power, and he was powerful.
Then plus he was well loved among the nation.
And he was well loved. You understand? This is one. This is another reason. This is why you men as leaders, man. If you are a leader, you got to, and you have authority, and you have power. You have power over a congregation. You have authority in a congregation. You know what I mean? You men have to even be more circumspect. Because you're gonna have women that admire you, look up to you, come to you for advice. You understand? And some of these women, you know, they got demons in them. And your job as a leader is not to take advantage of that. You feel what I'm saying? Your job as a leader, some of these sisters, they come from the world, they got all type of lust demons and stuff like that. And here you as a leader. You listening to them, you counseling them, bam, and then you end up having sex with the woman and so forth. That's why you men as a leader, you must learn to control that member when it comes to dealing with these women. You understand? You got to have control over it. You know, we ain't want to hear about none of you brothers that having sex with this sister and that sister and you're married and so forth. Or even if you all ain't married, you are single and you all having sex with this sister and that sister and you all are leaders. You understand? Now, let me say one thing. I remember what I wanted to say early on. Now, you know, like a lot of brothers, they get on us. They say, you brothers is weak because you all teach one wife. But you know how much strength it takes to control your mind, to control your lust, to control these things inside of you? It takes much more strength. A weak man gonna say, you know what? Let me have sex with her. You know, I'll take her to, you know what I mean? A weak man going to do that, but a strong brother going to be like, you know what? I want to set the right example for my nation. I'm going to control myself. I'm not going to have sex with this sister. You know what I mean? I'm not, you know what I mean? A strong brother going to, you know how much strength it takes to do that? You know what I mean? You know how much strength? So by definition, who is weak? You know what I mean?
No, they're the weak.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.